In 2021, over 800 people were arrested in a single day. Drug lords, money launderers, assassins, all betrayed by a phone they believed was untraceable. But what they didn't know was that every message they sent was being read by the FBI. This is the story of ANOM, a Trojan horse in your pocket, a global sting operation built on deception, digital espionage, and a hidden application pretending to be secured. This unbelievable story was uncovered in depth by investigative journalist Joseph Cox in his book Dark Wire, fully recommended to read, and he shared it also on stage at DEFCON 32, where he revealed details about ANOM that the world had never seen before. So I truly recommend to watch it as well. Before ANOM, there was Phantom Secure, ENCRYPTED, and Sky ECC. All of them encrypted phone companies that became the go-to communication tool for global criminal empires. Now, these weren't just secure devices. They were purpose-built for people who didn't want to be found. No GPS, no cameras, no microphones. Just military-grade messaging and a panic button that wiped everything in seconds. Phantom Secure had tens of thousands of users until the FBI took it down. ENCRYPTED, cracked by European law enforcement in 2020. And Sky ECC shut down after raids in Belgium and Canada. The market for encrypted crime tech was wide open, and someone had to fill it. It all started with one arrest, Vincent Ramos, the Canadian CEO of Phantom Secure. In 2018, he was taken into custody in the US, accused of selling secure phones to drug cartels. But this wasn't just an arrest, it was the start of a bigger plan. Now, according to court filings, Ramos agreed to cooperate, but more importantly, another figure stepped forward. A criminal developer who had created his own encrypted phone system. And he had a proposal, let me build it and you control it. And that was the beginning of Operation Trojan Shield. After Phantom Secure collapsed, the FBI saw an opportunity. What if instead of cracking encrypted phones, they become the supplier? And here enter ANOM. An encrypted phone system designed not to protect criminals, but to trap them. The FBI's inside man was an anonymous criminal developer. He approached the agency with a proposal. Let me build a new platform and I will distribute it through my trusted criminal connections. So ANOM was born as a joint operation between the FBI, the Australian Federal Police, the AFP, and the Europol. Its code name, Operation Trojan Shield. In Australia, it was called Operation Ironside. Now, ANOM phones looked like just normal Androids, except they were rigged. Every message went through FBI-controlled server in Pennsylvania, decrypted in real time, and forwarded to law enforcement teams around the globe. So much of what we know today about the inner workings of ANOM, its creation, operation, and eventual downfall comes from Cox's meticulous reporting in Dark Wire, which reconstructs the events like a cyber thriller. ANOM's brilliance wasn't in its tech, it was in its marketing. The FBI used their confidential source to distribute ANOM phones to known underworld brokers. But they didn't just push the product. They let the criminals sell it to each other. Genius. Trust is everything in criminal circles. So when gang leaders vouch for the phones, others followed. And by 2021, over 12,000 ANOM phones were in use across 100 countries, including Italy, Germany, Croatia, Serbia, the Netherlands, the US, and especially Australia, where over 1,600 phones were active. Criminals used ANOM to coordinate hits move cocaine, shipments, launder money, and plan attacks. All while the FBI and the AFP read every word in real time. I need a guy who can make a body disappear, make it painful. I will send location. This is a no message. March 2021. On June 7, 2021, after 3 years of surveillance, the trap was sprung. Law enforcement in 16 countries launched simultaneously raids coordinated down to the minute. They seized tons of drugs, millions in cash, hundreds of guns, and arrested more than 800 criminals. In Australia alone, 224 people were arrested. In Europe, hundreds more were caught red-handed, many with ANOM phones still in their nightstands. For the first time in modern history, a law enforcement agency didn't just watch criminal communications, they owned the network. AFP Commissioner Rhys Kircher said, "The FBI provided us with the platform. We provided the criminal users." As the headlines celebrated the takedown of criminal empires, questions began to surface. Was this operation too good to be true? Lawyers argued that ANOM blurred the line between surveillance and entrapment. The FBI didn't just monitor communications, it created them. Does this violate constitution protections or internal privacy laws? Leave your comments in the description. So in Germany and Sweden, courts reviewed whatever evidence from ANOM could be used at all. Digital rights activists raised alarms. If the FBI can do this, what stops authoritarian regimes from mimicking it? The criminal world didn't just lose the tool, it lost its trust network. ANOM triggered paranoia at every level. Rival gangs began accusing each other of being informants. Phone suppliers were interrogated, or worse. Entire supply chains collapsed. Some criminal leaders went back to non-digital methods, paper notes, burner phones, and signals. Meanwhile, new encrypted phone startups emerge, promising real security. But now, no one knows who to trust. Trojan Shield wasn't just a moment, it was a template. What ANOM proved is this: the next big surveillance breakthrough won't be about breaking encryption. It will be about controlling the platform itself. Already we are seeing new law enforcement tech mimicking this model. Fake VPNs, rogue marketplaces, deep fake trap accounts. And the dark web is wide open. But so is law enforcement. ANOM was just the beginning, because in the world of cybercrime, the biggest threat might already be in your pocket. So if you found the ethical dilemmas around ANOM fascinating, you will definitely want to check out my deep dive into Pegasus, the spyware sold by NSO Group that was used to infiltrate the phones of journalists, activists, and even heads of states. It's a chilling look at surveillance that doesn't require fake phones. It turns your real phone into a spy tool. You will find the link in the description and on the screen now as I speak. So go to watch it if you are interested. ANOM wasn't a software hack. It was a human hack. A story of deception, trust, and control. It exposed the truth we are still wrestling with today. The platform we use shaped the lives we live, even in crime. So the next time someone tells you their phone is untraceable, ask one question: who built it? Huge credit to Joseph Cox for uncovering this entire saga in his book Dark Wire, and for sharing exclusive material at DEFCON 32. Both were essential sources for this video. I'm Yaniv Hoffman. If this story fascinated you, subscribe and hit the bell, because next we are diving into ENCRYPTED, the system that cracked before ANOM took over. Stay safe, stay aware, and see you in the next video.